caving in. Do you ever feel already buried deep? 6 feet under screens and no one seems to hear a thing. Do you know that there's still a...
All right, guys, thank you for coming to class today. I hope everyone's caught up on their Game of Thrones project. So for our football update, we just played Missouri last week. Football, not good. I'm optimistic though, because we have good recruiting coming in. So 16th overall, just picked up a big recruit last week, and the worst has to be behind us, hopefully, or we're a basketball school. So today, we're going to be talking about leadership, and we're going to be looking at one of the greatest leaders of all time, James Goodnight. A couple things about him. He's the founder of SAS Institute, named one of America's top 25 most fascinating entrepreneurs. He is a relationship-style leader, and we'll be going into details of why he is a great leader throughout this presentation. Okay, so a couple of behaviors for James Goodnight. He's really into putting people first, and you guys, these are all on Blackboard in your slides, so please don't jot them all down. Really into autonomy, and he treats everyone fairly and is a great listener. Listening is very important. All right, Sam, how do you feel about your work environment for your employees?
Well, I believe achieving everyday low price is way more important than my employees' happiness.
Sam, I know you love saving money, but you should definitely invest in some things that will improve your work environment, such as windows. Next, we'll go over some leadership values that Goodnight has that might help get you on the right track.
Four of his unique leadership values are value people above all else, to give is to get, trust above all things, and ensure employees understand the significance of their work. All right, next we'll be talking about ethics. I know some of us here are known for being the most ethical. And Cheryl, how do you feel about respecting people's privacy and ethics?
I feel like everyone needs to be washed at home at work, so that's what we do.
And we won't even talk about Tyson regarding ethics and animal abuse.
Our basic philosophy for managing creative people is that you have to treat them as if they would make a difference. And if you do that, they will make a difference. You can't yell and scream at them. You can't do all of the. It's always done with very carefully. Set the clear desire of where you want to go. Make sure everybody understands it. And one of the ways we do that at SAS is through a communication. We use a lot of webcasts. I think there's an R&D webcast going on right now as we talk. But every 3 months I have a webcast that I tell people how the company's doing, what our direction is, what the most important things we're working on. And that same thing happens with the sales groups, the marketing groups, the R&D groups. So webcasts have become a very, very integral part of the way we communicate with our people.
And now we're going to have James Goodnight come in to speak to you all today. James, how does your approach to management differ from most?
As ascribed to the philosophy Esse Quam Vadiri, to be rather than seem. I don't subscribe to leadership fads. I believe that people trust you when you are genuine and authentic. Leaders are not perfect, but they demonstrate passion for what they do, practice their values consistently, and make decisions with others in mind. 95% of my assets drive out of the gates every night, and it's my job to make sure they come back the next day. Keeping employees and customers in mind has been the backbone of SAS's success as a business and as an employer.
If you could detail five core values that have attributed to SAS's overall success throughout the past four decades, what would they be?
That's a tough one. Our culture is based on three simple things: trust, flexibility, and values. SAS is a company built on relationships, and our relationship with customers are only going to be as good as our employees' experience at SAS. That experience is based on meaningful work, empowering leadership, and a world-class work environment. Our software is a product of the mind, and our employees are highly educated, creative people who love a challenge. Some studies show that challenging work is the most important factor in job satisfaction. To keep employees challenged, we trust and empower them to take risks and innovate. That keeps them happy, and when employees are happy, they keep our customers happy. We offer flexible hours to respect work-life balance. We design a stimulating work environment with fitness facilities, private offices, and artwork throughout to keep people inspired. If you treat people like they make a difference, they will make a difference. There is a direct correlation between our culture and our business success. While remaining privately held, SAS just celebrated the 39th year of uninterrupted revenue growth and profitability. It's a virtuous cycle. Treat employees well, and they innovate well. This creates happy customers. Happy customers impact revenue. Revenue enables us to reinvest in our employees and our customers. It just makes sense.
Thank you for coming to speak to us. Class, do you have any questions?
Is it true that you're the richest person in North Carolina?
It is.
Cool. You guys got any more questions for Mr. Goodnight?
All right, everyone get ready for the quiz. Please clear off your desks. All right, you have 10 minutes. Please begin.